Teresa Prego from EpiWatch. I'm the CEO. And I wanted to show you first some faces. Epilepsy impacts 3.5 million individuals in the United States. You might or might not guess these individuals have epilepsy. You're much less likely to guess that they all have lost their lives to SUDEP or sudden death from epilepsy. Injury and death is a significant risk for people living with epilepsy and a significant source of anxiety for their caregivers, family members, and loved ones. This is the genesis of EpiWatch. We are a software as a medical device running on the Apple Watch that detects tonic-clonic or grand mal seizures, is our first entry point, alerts, so you have set up a care network that is notified when you have a seizure, phone, text, email. Email's not really a big selection. And then it alerts on the watch itself. There's an audible alarm that's set off. And then the action can be taken. If they have a rescue med, it can be administered, a seizure safety plan in a school setting. The school nurse can come with the rescue medication on the campus setting. Campus safety is alerted. And that is our primary audience initially, is that pediatric and young adult living independently for the first time. We are the result of a long-term collaboration between Apple, Johns Hopkins, and EpiWatch. We also, in addition to the detect, alert, and act, have continuous data recorded about that seizure. The current standard of care for seizure reporting is either patient-reported or caregiver-reported, so not accurate and very much under-reporting of seizures, yet decisions are made based on that, that information. When we looked at where do we go, what platform should we run on, 69% of people surveyed with epilepsy who were wearing a health wearable were wearing the Apple Watch. So rather than forcing them to go somewhere we wanted them to go, we went to where they actually already were utilizing the wearable. And if you look at that audience, people with epilepsy with a smartwatch or consumer wearable, they're likely to be our early adopters. And that market, just in and of itself, is fairly significant. And this is US only, based on subscription of $19.99 a month. Our revenue, based on conservative market capture, very, very conservative for this year. We are on the market now for 2 weeks with our early access users. And then we anticipate that goes to 3 million in 2026 and then grows from there. We have not included in this projection utilization by pharma partners where we are used in clinical studies and particularly ambulatory studies. Our go-to-market approach is initially via advocacy platforms and the community where the epilepsy community has already gathered. Reddit is a huge source of communication and education, interestingly, TikTok and Facebook. And then the advocacy partners, like Danny did, Epilepsy Foundation and others, have been huge supporters and have promoted EpiWatch on their sites as well. We are currently initiating a raise of $3 million to expand our commercial infrastructure, our customer support infrastructure, and to expand beyond that advocacy platform marketing and promotion. Our team is Sam and myself, who have spent the last several days here with MedTech Innovator, and thanks, huge shout out to you guys. This has been an amazing group and time. And then our two founders, Nathan Crone and Greg Krause, who are leading epileptologists from Johns Hopkins, who really saw this issue and wanted to do more to address it. I do want to, before I really say thank you, I want to take you back to those faces that we started with, because the one thing that we're asked by investors fairly frequently is, you know, will people really use it? What is the impact? And how does this work, this intersection of consumer wearable and med device? Look at Rose. Look at Rose's wrist. Rose was a runner. She was in the woods, had a seizure, landed face down. Her dad realized that she hadn't come back for her run, went to check on her, and when he found her, it was too late. if we had been available at that point in time, she already had the Apple Watch on, could have put EpiWatch app on there, and the outcome might have been significantly different. And that is why we are doing what we're doing. Thank you.